two sides
to everything
of the bill.
Yeah.
And pulling out the ones. And the purple, and the purple is now stitched.
Oh, you did.
It's not dyed. It's
regular. You're so cute.
Yeah, you make sure you can.
Put your ginger ale so I don't belch.
So we're going to put the cash in here.
I love ginger ale.
Hello.
Hey, this is Mark.
Hi, guys.
He's the cop. This is my brother.
There's Mark the cop.
He works for
Mark the cop.
Oh, all right. Donna, can you pull the...
Yeah, wait a minute. Your sister came from Wisconsin.
We don't have...
Hola!
This is it.
Beautiful. And wear that purple scarf.
And wear the purple scarf.
Whoa!
We're going to unscream at our minds tonight. We surely came through.
You put your clothes on, then put this on over it.
Okay. Jimmy gave us a rose.
You have to get clean water today.
Oh, good. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Opal and I are love interests in the...
yeah, we have a little wagon thing. It's a wagon and a soup thing.
Dialogue. So much dialogue.
Well, I'm going to have all my coats on.
Oh, okay.
Coats are so
funny.
So I'm wearing it all during the show. So this is for Natalie. And Saul says, if you was a lush, we'd take you to Alcoholics Anonymous. This is my brother, Lauren.
Lauren?
L-O-R-E-N.
Lauren.
For Fox News in Cleveland.
Wow, Fox News.
Yeah.
You have a foxy sister and you're a Fox News.
God, this is Dean. Dean the doctor. Dean the doctor?
You listen to the owl thing.
The owl thing, okay, great.
Hoot owl.
Hoot owl. Okay. Yes.
And I always goof it up, but not tonight.
Not tonight, because you're
I
here.
I sure not.
Not screwed up tonight.
Because President Clinton's in the audience.
Dean, what can I tell you? It's Dean. Dean. Here it is.
Is that cool?
Where are you?
Besides playing solid, I'm also the voice of Mr. Tanner.
That's right, he's the voice of Mr. Tanner.
Mr. Tanner passed, but that's right.
If they ever get anything for old people, let me know.
That would be funny if he came down with the ceiling.
I said we could have a mother. I could go, meow!
Oh, my God, those aren't good.
Yeah, I know. Look at these, man, and yours are so
good.
Just cut the bottoms off.
It's not really that much. Yeah, cut the bottoms
off. There's water right here.
Oh, those are pretty.
Hey, how about one of those bottles?
Yeah.
There's not much room. This is plenty of room.
How about one of your empty perfume bottles?
Ah, yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah, that's cool.
Welcome to the Everybody Loves Opal set on a Saturday night. Why am I doing here? Oh, wait, it's just through the show. Thank you for coming, and I hope you have a wonderful time tonight. And I don't know what else to say, so enjoy and see why everybody loves Opal.
Backstage, here. Look at that. The cellar.
Cool.
That's the cellar, and this is the pulley that holds the little wagon up in the air. And they wrap it around here. This is my plant. It's pathetic. And see, I put my little wagon there, and then I drag it right, pull it right up there. I only have to do it once. Hair tonic. Good, it's cough medicine. I switched bottles. It's wonderful stuff. Sort of paralyzes your throat. That's about it. There ain't much here.
This one. Big serum.
Yeah,
just like this. Mm-hmm. Just one of these real quick.
All of these. I'll see you later, Alex.
This morning to get here for this performance. We did. Which would be
half an hour.
Good evening.
Good evening.
How y'all doing tonight?
Good.
My name is Jimmy Chang and I want to welcome you to tonight's production. Thank you all very, very much for coming. I cannot see an empty chair, but then again, I'm blind without glasses. Even with glasses. So, because even though this is a three-act comedy, intermission will occur once only after the first act. The second and third acts will be in the second half of the show. and intermission will be 20 minutes long, so you may purchase any concessions that you'd like at the stands to support the city of Gulfport. And also, after the show, we welcome you to take advantage of a Gulfport Community Players tradition and meeting and greeting the cast who will be entering the lobby. So, again, thank you very much for coming, and this week has been an interesting week. We welcome new world champions, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers of football.
Yeah!
Yeah! And this week we spent a lot of time preparing for this wonderful production. It's a lot of fun putting it on. And so sit back, relax, and you will see, hopefully, why everybody loves Opal. Thank you very much for coming.
Funny. Any friend of this young lady's is a friend of mine.
Charming place. Did you do it yourself?
Brad's the chemist in our firm. He used to be a professor, taught chemistry in one of the biggest colleges in the USA of America. He knows how to make perfume, salt, soap, you name it, he can make it.
It sure pays to have a trade, don't it?
Feel free to call on me if you ever need soap.
Oh, ain't you nice? Thank you. Now, how about a nice cup of tea, honey?
Well, frankly, we just come to see about more than perfume bottles, thank you.
That's the trouble with the world today. Everybody runs around like they're 15 minutes late. Now you sit down. How do you like your tea?
Strong. Weakness is only attractive in women.
Honey, did you hear that?
You got yourself a real comical fella. Good thing I ain't around you much. I'd be on the floor. It wouldn't surprise me.
How do you like your tea, honey?
Frankly, it's immaterial.
If you'd showed up before the cat, you could have had cream.
Sugar's all I want.
Just look over in that barrel, honey. You'll find a can that says Hershey's. That's sugar. I'm getting so blind lately, I can't tell salt from sugar, so I put everything in cans with big letters.
Wouldn't glasses simplify your problem?
Oh, I intend to get glasses, just as soon as somebody throws away a pair that fits me.
Is this it?
Well, one or two things gotta happen pretty soon. Either my eyes gotta get better, or my arms gotta get longer. That's sugar. Salt's in a mothball can. Just shake out what you want, honey. I left my spoon upstairs. I was using it to get my shoes on.
Professor, I've been mighty curious to know what you do with all them empty French perfume bottles.
Well, see.
Hey, had that cough, Lord?
Not long. 10 years.
It ain't a cold. It's his lung.
Don't move. It just so happens I got something guaranteed to stop coughing. Money back. What does that say, honey?
Hair tonic.
That's it. Cough medicine here. Take a swig.
Thank you. No, I'm strangled if you don't mind.
It is hair tonic, honest. I switched bottles. It's wonderful stuff. Sort of paralyzes your throat.
Drink your tea before you choke. Well, I'll explain, Opal. You see, Paris, France give my boss, Mr. Solomon Bozo, their exclusive recipe to make all their Paris, France perfume, which I sell from door to door at half the price. Only we run out of genuine Paris, France bottles, so we gotta use used ones, see? I mean, that's the fact of the matter.
Oh, now I know what kind you want. I've been digging them out of my bargain basement. I'll fetch them up while the tea cools. If you want soda crackers with your tea, you find them in the barrel that says roofing tar. They're in a box marked soap flakes.
I told you she was a real creep.
For future explanations, Mr. Mulock, the word isn't recipe, it's formula. And while on the subject of selling from door to door, I suggest you inspire a little more confidence if you didn't wear that tight, knee-length sweater. No need to prove you're a mammal.
Frankly, I don't know what a mammal is. And in addition and furthermore, I don't care. You stick to your religion, and I'll stick to mine. Opal, I'm coming down to help you.
She found out the perfume was phony. She called the cops.
How can a woman that bought bootleg perfume complain to the police?
She was a policewoman. I was taking a shower when the cops come and search the house. I opens up the door, naked as a grape, and there's these gorillas.
What did you say?
I says, selling tickets to the policeman's ball, pal. He says, yeah, and I want to have a voice dance with you. 41 previous arrests, I ain't never been handcuffed naked.
How did you get out of it?
I says, look, pal, I got a constitutional right to dry myself. So this Elliot Ness shoves me into the John to get dressed, and I beats it out through the little window. I hope they drown in your damn Chanel. What bugs me? Small business just ain't got a chance.
Don't worry, Saul, you will bounce back with the resiliency of a rubber sheet.
You insult me?
Am I?
I don't know. That's what makes me sore. Next time you insult me, you tell me.
What a shabby trio we are. The trouble is, we're all failures, so we deluded ourselves into believing we could succeed in crime. But we overlook the fact that it takes the same degree of ability to be successfully dishonest as it does to be honestly successful.
I ain't no failure. It just ain't a success.
We're doomed to mediocrity. And why not? A girl with a pea pod brain, a man drained of decency, and a midget Machiavelli.
Oh, that's right. Call me names. You was a crummy drunk at a cruddy bar when I picked you up and gave you a decent job making the very best bootleg point deal. Top brands, genuine bottles. That's gratitude.
Forgive me if I wound you.
Well, just because I'm a bum don't mean I ain't sensitive.
I'll try to remember. You're a bum.
That's better. Get the idiot, Goyle. We don't need no poison bottles now.
Gloria! Oh, Miss Gulak. Gulak. Sounds like a stew made of zebra meat and flotsam.
Wait a minute. Who lives here?
The Bride of Dracula.
You mean a dame?
Not in a classic sense.
I noticed on the way in here, there ain't another house with his
mind. I can read your mind. It wouldn't work.
Why not?
Because this Jen has a flaw. She's honest.
Yeah, but is she smart?
Well, she's not exactly retarded, but I wouldn't bet on her against a chimpanzee.
Then she's quite stupid and honest. Yeah, I'm up here. You think I ain't a big-time operator? You just watch me operate.
Another symbol of my downward progress.
Well, now, let's see what goodies we got at this scrub bag.
$10.
This here's our latest French item, our Petty's Mantra.
I'll take it. Won't Mr. Tiana be surprised? Oh, well, you just stay here, make yourself some more tea while I go up and chase the bats out of your rooms. Want to see that mess up there now? You want your $10? Then I wouldn't have no perfume. All right, don't nobody tell me.
Wait, it was raining.
So, big shots. I told you that it smells out in a bungalow court. And you thought planting roses would fool them.
Shut up. Why did I hit you in the hooter? It was you what done it.
Me?
You rang the doorbell of a police woman.
Well, how was I to know? I ain't got an x-ray brain.
You have one of the components, a vacuum tube.
All right, oh, okay, yeah. Knock it off. Be safe out of here as long as that old rag bag goes to Texas.
Oh! You dirty crook! You lousy, stinking crook!
What's bugging you?
Somebody's been filching dough out of my purse for a whole month, so I marked a bill. And I caught you right-handed, you lousy, sneaky thief!
I never took a penny out of your purse. I swear it on the Bible.
I wouldn't get near you with the Bible. I'd get struck by lightning.
Look, I can explain everything. I just need a little time.
All right, explain it!
Yes, I have a clinical interest.
All right, you just loused yourself up. I'll tell him. He took it out of your purse. I know, because I took it out of his coat. Feeling that he'd been stealing your money, and this way I proved it. Get out of that. I've got a clinical interest.
Hey! You've been filching my money?
That's right. But you're wrong chronologically. I've been stealing from you for much more than a month.
So you heard him! He's been robbing me! I can't go to the police! Hit him!
You've been stealing her money?
Yes, but it's not her money.
Don't listen to him, Saul. Hit him!
I discovered that Miss Gulak's been charging more for our product than we agreed upon and pocketing the difference. I took it upon myself to, shall we say, balance the budget.
Is he telling the truth?
No, he's lying! Cover him!
You've been stealing her money!
Please! All right! But if he's been stealing his share, he's been holding out on you.
Yeah. Stealing her money, you've been holding out me, you high-class bum.
May I tell you a little fable? Three rats fell in a barrel. If they'd used their teeth intelligently, they could have gnawed a hole and escaped. But they didn't. They fought. One by one, they ate each other, and none survived. Need I labor the point?
Frankly, I wouldn't eat a rat like you.
Yeah, you want your nose broke? Fran's right. We gotta use our teeth together. This is the best luck we had yet. The cops will never smell out our operation in a dump like this.
I ain't sure. If Opal ever found out we're phony, she'd squawk to the cops herself.
I could stop that.
I suppose you'd knock her off.
What's so funny?
You couldn't kill a fly.
The hell I couldn't. Besides, who'd miss her?
No neighbors, no telephone. Couldn't ask for better insurance.
Wait a minute. You give me an idea. Suppose something did happen to Opal, and we had insurance on her.
She'd have to be related.
Gruesome thought.
Suppose we made her a partner. Couldn't we insure her for business reasons, then knock her off? We could never make that much out of perfume.
Dear Miss Gulak, do you know what beguiles me about you? Your utter femininity.
What's wrong with being ambitious?
Don't knock it, Brad. She's got a good idea. Something like this could make us real pros.
$15,000. That's five apiece.
At least your mathematics are beyond reproach.
5,000 on a silver platter.
Like the head of John the Baptist.
That ain't thinking big. Suppose it was a $30,000 box.
$10,000. No more cheap shirts. No more cheap food. No more cheap people.
No more dancing in them dark joints where the only light comes from a jukebox.
No more hustling for a fast buck. One little moya, and I could be honest. chance with your ears burning?
Not on that third floor. It's cold as an icebox.
Well, the three of us were just saying how we can't remember never taking the Nobline as much as we talk to you.
Well, I'll tell you something. When I was a little girl, I was as dirty and ugly as anything you've ever seen, but I just loved everybody. I couldn't hate nobody if I tried. And nobody hates me. Maybe I ain't got a million bucks, but I ain't got an enemy in the world.
Now, that's a coincidence. You wouldn't think it to look at me, but I'm a philosopher, too, would you?
But he is, honest, a real slob.
And I'll prove it to you. While you was upstairs, we had a conference, and you know what we decided on?
We're going to take you in business with us.
Make you a silent partner.
Oh, I can't do that.
Oh, you opened your home to us. It's only right we should open our hearts to you.
Tit for tat. Well, ain't you the nicest people? It just goes to show that you love everybody no matter what. They gotta love you back. It ain't ever fooled me yet.
Do you mind if I ask you a personal question, Opal?
Judith, I got no secrets.
You got any relatives?
No, I'm the last of the crunkies.
You ever been insured?
What for?
Well, a decent burial for one thing.
I don't worry. They ain't left nobody above ground yet.
The reason I ask, we gotta protect the business. You got any objections to being insured?
It won't cost you a red cent.
We'll deduct you from our taxes.
We figured you was doing us a favor.
We all of us got insured on each other, didn't we, Brad?
A double indemnity.
Judith, if you want to get insured, you go ahead. I wouldn't want you to be out of pocket. Ain't she a dear?
Now, you have to be examined by an insurance doctor.
That's all right. If he finds anything, I'll share it with him. But you gotta promise me something.
We're partners.
You gotta promise if I pass on before Mr. Tanner, you'll take care of him?
I'll take care of your cat personally, Opal.
Oh, cross our hearts.
Gloria, you're a real sweet girl. And you're good men, too. I ain't ever fooled. Well, let's lap up our tea. You know what I'm going to do? Make a toast. I drink this tea to my new friends. If you got friends in this world, nothing bad can happen to you. And that's the truth. To success in all your plans and everything else you set out to do. God bless all good men and bad ones, too.
Son.
Oh.
How old are you?
Judith, I don't know.
49, 55?
Why don't you split the difference? Say 50.
You don't know your exact age.
Never did. Doctor, you must be just miserable. Why don't you let me give your head a twist?
Do you know when your birthday is?
Halloween.
But that is not a date.
What is it then?
You were born on Halloween.
I'm a duck. Whenever I see the pumpkins out, I know I'm a year older.
Oh. All right, I just split the difference and say 50. But wait, I'm not finished.
I know. I'm going to move the stove behind your back. It'll warm you up.
What is your occupation?
Collector.
Art? Or garbage?
Junk.
Your parents' occupation?
Junk.
Hmm. How far back?
The Mayflower.
Do you have any birthmark or deformity?
Why?
Identification.
Do I have to say?
Do you want this policy?
It's kind of embarrassing. Well, I was born with 6 toes on 1 foot.
Does it impair you walking?
No, it helps.
Doctor has 11 toes, age and posture. Married? It's a well-known ornithological fact that hoot owls occasionally propagate.
Not this old hoot owl. Your back in any warmer, that?
Oh, all right. Now, I shall now ask you if there's any evidence or history, past or present, of the following diseases.
Wait a minute. It's kind of drafty in this room. I don't want you going out of here worse off than when you come in. This ought to protect you some.
No. Have you ever had any convulsions?
No.
Have you ever had any trouble with your heart?
No.
Stomach?
No.
Lungs?
No.
Spleen?
No. Doctor, if that stove gets too hot on your back, I'll move it for you.
Spleen?
No.
Liver?
No.
Kidneys?
No.
Muscles?
No.
Appendix?
No.
Goiter?
Doctor, when you're done with me, would you take a look at my cat? He slobbers when he sleeps.
Madam, I am not a veterinarian.
Doctor, I ain't a man.
Any diseases when you were a child?
Just freckles.
clinic, a sanitarium or institution?
Yes!
Have you ever had it? Did you say yes?
Yes!
Which one?
All of them!
What for?
Pots.
Pots?
They got so many flower pots left, they don't know what to do with them, I haul them away.
No! I mean, have you ever been in for observation?
No!
You're positive.
Doctor, your coat's all done. Better put it on. You look all worn out. You just sit here while I make us a nice cup of tea.
I do not drink tea. I do not drink coffee. I do not drink intoxicating liquor. I drink water that is boiled or goat's milk. And I don't want either at this moment. All I want to do is get out of here and see my psychiatrist.
Well, just sit tight while I make myself a cup. 2 minutes ain't gonna kill you. I sure wish you'd look at Mr. Tan. I hate to see him drool like that. I've done it. Sorry if I scared you, but I bet the kink's gone out of your shoulder. Why don't you get up? Doctor, can you see this?
How dare you! How dare you put your hands on me? Why, you might have crippled me for life! Why? Why, if I suffer any ill effects from this...
Doctor, you're moving your neck.
All right. Where is that cat of yours who spotted in his sleep?
Victory. Where's she?
I'm back counting bottles.
Saul, I cannot endure another day of her moronic bromides. That congenital optimist greets each day with such determined goodwill that the sun never sets. It flees. We've had the policy a month now. When do we liquidate?
I'm working on it.
Reading the obituaries?
I'm looking for ideas. Golf ball kills Void Watcher. Nah. How about this? A woman was trapped in her own icebox. The victim was discovered by an uninformed police
uniformed.
Now. Oh, we ain't got an icebox anyhow. Save some good poisons we can use.
Hydrogen cyanide, carbon monoxide, aerosol insecticide. A pity we couldn't poison her using one of her own deadly homilies.
Homilies? Nah, name some other poisons.
Ground glass.
How about rat poison?
Well, would she eat it?
But put it in a tea bag.
What if us might? It's too dangerous. What about an accident? An explosion in the stove?
You don't want us to freeze to death.
Gloria should be here right now. This calls for feminine guile.
Opal, you shouldn't be carrying around no heavy boxes. Where you want
them? Over there. I gotta load them in the wagon and haul them into town. Thank you, honey.
No more heavy lifting. You got 2 men around here.
And it sure is good. Outside of Mr. Tiana, there ain't been a male here since Pa got killed. Do you know?
How'd your old man die, Opal?
Got drunk and fell in the well.
You went outside?
Yep. I never pull up water, but when I think of him down there yelling and cussing and nobody be hearing.
How deep is the well?
Deep enough. Guess it was for the best. He beat my ma to death. He would have done the same to me if he lived.
How did you happen to discover him?
Oh, after about a week, I wondered where he was at. So I asked a friend of mine, traffic cop, nice fellow, real genuine, got run over. Anyhow, I asked him to find Pa, so he sent out some detectives, and sure enough, they found him, stiff as usual.
And they accepted it as an accident?
Sure, sort of runs in the family. Same thing happened to my grandpa, same well. Is it D'Stroganoff? You know what some joker wanted me to put on the tombstone? Let me see if I can remember. It's just awful. Benjamin Cronky never touched water till he got drunk and fell in the well. Best thing he ever done for his daughter. Ended up soaked in halfway to hell. I am ashamed of being like that.
Did you use it?
Of course not. I wouldn't do a mean thing like that. No use kicking a dead horse. Well, I got my work cut out. I guess you got things to do, too. Might as well take this up with me while I'm going. As Grandma Cronky always said, use your head and save your heels. Hey, listen, I hope that story I told you about the well ain't upset you. I had steps put inside so it couldn't happen to no more Cronky.
Started.
I thought we had it made. It just ain't no justice. She had steps put in. I got a hunch she's gonna be about as easy to get rid of as a hornet's nest. Well, if it ain't this universe back from her travels, where the hell you been?
It's Halloween. I invite Opal a birthday present.
What is it? A poison pumpkin.
I got a plan all figured out. It's perfect. She'll never know what hit her. Wait till you see. Oh, where's she at?
Upstairs with the facts.
Well, are you going to keep us in suspense?
I knew if I waited for you two to dream up a way, she'd die of old age. Well, here it is.
There must be more than meets the eye.
Listen.
It's lousy, but it won't kill her.
I'm afraid there's something naive in your approach to crime, Mr. Locke.
I'll explain how it's gonna work. I went over it last night all by myself. Look, her wagon is up there at the head of the stairs. It's held up there by that pulley. The end of the rope is hooked over the wooden plug. That plug is loose. It goes through the wall. You can see it when you're in the basement. Now, I went down there and I tied a string to the plug. The string leads under the floor and up through this rat hole. Now, if I pull the string, watch that plug. The string will pull the plug through. The rope will fly off, the pulley will let loose, and the wagon will come scooting down the ramp.
So you're gonna run around with that little wagon?
Look, right up above, my rooms are filled with tons of newspapers and heavy junk. And what's holding the ceiling up? That one post. When the wagon hits that, it'll knock the post loose. And you know what'll happen to the ceiling?
It will collapse and crush anyone standing underneath it.
A natural accident.
And of course she'll accommodate us by hanging them.
I got all that figured out too. I'll hook the string to the key of the merry-go-round. Then as the key winds the string up, we'll call her to come down to wish her a happy birthday. By the time she reaches the middle of the stairs, the string will pull the plug through.
Get it hooked up.
Have you gnawed a hole in the table to get the string through?
There's a crack in the table right over the hole in the floor. Quick, somebody help me!
How are we supposed to do this?
Now, what are we doing now?
We're going to take this string and put
gonna
it
go up this
crack right here.
Opal here!
Professor Bradford Winter.
Where's Opal?
She ain't here. I mean, she had to go upstairs. Excuse me. Opal! Opal! Opal!
She done something? We're all friends.
Oh, so are we devoted.
I thought maybe she'd park a wagon in a no parking spot.
No, we were fixing a birthday present for Miss Cronky.
Yes, it's Opal's birthday. We're fixing a present.
Today?
Yeah, Halloween. It's her birthday. Today, Halloween.
It's a funny day to be born.
Yeah, ain't it? Halloween. Imagine.
Don't know who belong. Who, her?
A him?
Me? How does one measure friendship in days or devotion?
Well, look who's here! Mr. Sherlock Holmes himself! Hiya, Joe! You handsome devil! You get better looking every time I see you. This here's my friend, Joe Yankee, spelled with a J. Swedish. Oh, my mother used to make Swedish meatballs. Well, then you got something in common right off the bat. Why ain't you been to see me lately? Got a girl now?
Aren't you still my girl? Did she ever tell you how she got me a promotion?
Well, I wouldn't have done it if I'd known you was going to make such a nuisance of yourself.
There was a murder case we couldn't solve. Opal found the revolver in the trash can and turned it over to me. Fingerprints and all.
Sweet!
Do you wonder? I keep an eye on her.
Well, you can just get married and stay home. I got my own friends here now.
They got something planned for you, so I'll let them get on with it.
Who's planning what and when?
It's a secret, Opal. I'd stay, but I'm on duty. Glad to see you're in good hands. Goodbye, sweetheart. Take care.
Nice fella, real genuine. Mother has asthma. They give her up for dead twice. What's the secret?
Oh, we were planning a surprise for you, and he surprised us.
Oh, we'll give you a hint. Seen any witches lately?
Oh, no, you didn't.
The fact of the matter is, we got a little birthday present.
I hope you ain't serious.
It ain't much, but you go upstairs while we get it ready. And don't peek. We'll tell you when.
I don't know what to say. I thought you was up to something. You've been whispering. Give me warning. I got a surprise for you, too.
What's she mean by that?
Who knows? Come on, let's get it fixed.
Are you nuts? We can't go through this now. That cop just left.
Yeah, and he'll give us a perfect alibi. We can say we was thinking only of her happiness when there was an accident.
Actually, we couldn't have planned it better.
Quick, somebody help.
What if it don't work? What if the ceiling don't come down?
It'll come down. I tested that post. It's about to break now.
I hope so.
I still think we ought to wait.
Why? It's her birthday. The neatness of it appeals to me. It rounds out a fiscal year.
I'm going to go to Hollywood and get in movies. Or maybe I'll marry me a millionaire.
All set?
Yeah. Now, when she gets halfway down, I'll start the merry-go-round. When she hears the music, she'll stop right under where we want her.
Yeah, suppose she don't.
She will. It's human nature.
She ain't human. She come out of her squirrel hole.
Stand behind the way. Try not to look apprehensive, Saul.
All right, I'm going to yell for her to come down. So, when I give you a signal, turn off the lights. After all, we don't want to see her hurt.
What signal?
After happy birthday, I'll throw her a kiss. That'll be the signal.
Smile.
Opal, everything's all set. Opal, trick or treat. Opal, we're ready.
So am I.
Then come on down for your surprise.
Everybody. Thank you. Thank you. I'm taking Eileen's place, and I thought I would have to dress to do something to get out of my paint clothes. Welcome to Gulfport Community Players production of Everybody Loves Opal. We opened last night to a full house and had a wonderful, wonderful time, so you people are all in for a great treat tonight. We also have a tradition here at Gulfport of greeting our actors after the performance. So when the curtain is over and the final applause is over, the actors will go out into the lobby and will be very happy to greet you there and talk about the performance of the show if you'd like to meet them there. They enjoy that very much, and I think most of our people do too. Tonight we have our scene set at the edge of the city dump in an old rundown house where Opal lives. And her little adventures there over a period of a few weeks that are going to take place are going to be presented to you on the stage tonight. And it's a thriller, and it's a mystery, and it's a heartwarming drama, and we know that you will all enjoy it very much. And this gives me a chance to get dressed up. So without any more, I hope you all enjoy the show. Thank
Who are you?
You.
Who are you? Are you?
I'm Helen Paramore. For the set. I did the set decoration, so mostly people are used to seeing me around the theater in paint clothes, so I made quite a sensation when I went backstage tonight. And I guess I did front stage too. Hope you enjoy the show.
$39.98. Now, why would you do that? Take it back.
Lord, ain't my life worth at least $39?
wish that was you. You got your whole sweet life ahead of you. You know, if I had my life to live over again, there's only two things I'd want that I ain't got. Big bosoms and long eyelashes. There's three things that we can't resist. That's two of them. The other's coming. You got everything, and I got confidence in you.
I got nothing. Frankly, I don't even have an opinion anymore.
You've been awful twitchy lately. You know what I think you need? A husband.
Oh, right.
What about my friend, that cop you met here, Joe Yankee? Ain't he a handsome devil?
Yeah, for a wedding present, I could give him my fingerprints.
What about the professor? He ain't married, is he? Brad?
Frankly, that man hates the whole female sex.
Oh, that's all right. So do most women. I think you'd land him if you played your cards right.
Any girl that played cards with him would find herself in a barrel, roped and raped.
Oh, now, Gloria, you don't mean that. Brad's a booky, brainy, educated college professor.
Yeah, he's got 6 college degrees and 1 lung, some husband.
What happened to his other lung?
Oh, he got loaded one night and accidentally killed a man with his car, so he went to prison. And that's where his lung went. No college in the USA of America wants him now, and neither do I.
Oh, the trouble some people have. He's such a nice fellow, real genuine.
Genuine? If he was really so mentally intellectual, he wouldn't use all them big words just to prove he was so superior.
It does seem like using a cannon to shoot a rabbit.
Frankly, I wouldn't want him even with 2 lungs. He's got a dirty mind.
He's a man, honey.
Once, when just everything was going wrong, I said I wish I could dig a hole and climb in and hide. You know what he said to me? He said my trouble was I wanted to go back to my mother's womb.
That was a mean thing to say.
Can you imagine? I hated my mother.
Maybe he just had a bad day.
No, he's like that. Ever heard of Jekyll and Hyde?
I've seen the movie.
Well, wait till you see his Hyde side.
I can't understand how a nice girl like you ain't married.
Well, frankly, every fella I ever fell for turned out to be dumb, drunk, or drafted.
Well, there's somebody for you somewhere, and I'm gonna dig him up.
Frankly, what's so important about getting married anyway?
Well, I'll tell you, if you got somebody, everything's better. Even what's bad is better. And that's the truth.
Then why didn't you get married?
Because I was always ugly as a mud fence, but you. You're as pretty as a peony.
Oh, I'm sorry you were so ugly.
Oh, it ain't bad. There's one good thing about being ugly. You never worry about losing your looks.
You're big-headed. You just won't see that in anything.
Well, I believe in live and let live. And now I need you left. Let me make you a cup of tea.
Okay. If it's gonna make you happy,
why, you just being here makes me happy. You know, I got only one worry. That Falsiers and the professor got me scared.
Scared? What do you mean?
I'm afraid they're gonna move and take you with them.
Oh.
I tell you now, I don't think I can get used to living alone again. Mr. Tanner ain't enough. Honey, I want you to know now, if you ever need a home, you've got one here as long as you live. I owe you that for my life. Now, don't say nothing. You just sit here and relax while I get some rags and dust out your room. Mr. Tanner? Mr. Tanner, where are you at? Wake up, you bad boy. While you're out of your room, I'll just lock Mr. Tanner in and let him mouse around your shoes. You know something? This sweet old cat and me has been together 15 years. We've lasted longer than most marriages.
She's great.
Dumpty, dump, dump, drift wood. Do-dee-do, no, drift wood.
Well, I see Lady Esther finally drug her tail out of bed.
Where's the Batwoman?
She's upstairs, mousing.
are you in a snit for?
Nothing. If you want to sneak out of here every morning before I get up, don't think I'm going to ask where you went.
You wouldn't understand anyhow. For 3 mornings now, we've been hiding out in the bushes.
Sol has a plan worked out, but first we had to double check on which way Opal goes into town.
And today, when she takes her little wagon out on the highway, it's going to be an accident.
Today?
If it were done when 'tis done, 'twere well if it were done quickly. Macbeth, a play.
I know I was in it at high school. I was a witch. And you know what I had to say? Double, double, toil and trouble. And I still say it.
Trouble. I got my bumpers wrapped in gunny sack. We need that to sponge them off.
Oh, Peachy, so you're going to sneak up behind her and run her down like a rabbit?
What are you all of a sudden? The SPCA?
I think we ought to wait.
For what?
Let her die by herself.
That's what I'm going to do.
Sol has perfected a plan. We must rely on his superior wisdom.
Why? Solomon ain't no Solomon.
What's bugging you?
Nothing. I just decided I don't want a Hollywood career, and I don't want to marry a millionaire.
Yeah, you want your teeth caked in?
I want to be counted out. She thinks I saved her life. Look, she gave me her last $39 to buy a dress.
$39? You're going to get $10,000.
Wait a minute, Saul. We have a casualty here. This poor bewitched bitch is a victim of benevolence.
Well, what you got to say, Gloria?
I say live and let live.
Oh, Gloria, don't tell me you've allowed your shining armor of avarice to be corroded by conscience. Where is the Gloria we all knew and loved with her venal virtues and... Minuscule brain viewers comprehend what's happened to you? Don't you know that kindness is a lethal weapon? You've allowed yourself to be knocked senseless by an imbecile armed with a platitude.
Well, for the first time in my whole entire life, somebody's got entire confidence in me. Confidence! C-O-N-F-F.
F as in foolish, I as in idiot, D as in dumb.
Frankly, I don't care how you spell it. Opal's been good to me, and you're gonna have to kill her over my dead body.
She called a shot.
Dear Miss Gulak, can't you see that horrible old harridan is nothing but a pot of poison honey? You're committing suicide. You're jumping into a river of molasses.
If I want to commit suicide, I got a right to jump into anything I want.
You don't have to jump, doll. I'll push you.
Come on! Kill me!
Kill you? You ain't sure. I'll be back after a station break.
Maybe Saul will kill you, but I promise, if you oppose us in any way, I will slit that slim throat of yours. I will slice you into slivers and dispose of you in the disposal. Now get dressed, wash your face. I deplore untidiness.
What about that religious jazz, a conscience yet?
She can't harm us without incriminating herself. Now if Opal's on time, she's due to leave here right now.
Don't bug me about Gloria. I thought I was a good judge of character.
Stop. Look terrific.
Dippy. Again. That's enough.
I'll stand.
On 12?
I'm conservative.
You back already? So all your perfume?
We hit a slump.
The perfume business is like anything else. Dog eat dog. Don't nobody open Gloria's door. I got Mr. Tiana locked inside. You know what he done? Curled right up on her bed and started purring.
Oh.
A pity people can't purr. Can you think of anything nicer than a room full of people all sitting around purring? I get started on my roof. If I don't, then big rubbish trucks will beat me to the very worst.
Allow me.
If you want something to read, there's plenty here. Why, some of these newspapers is older than you are. I find new news and old news just about the same anyhow. Nothing changes but names and dates. Men get killed for a dime. Women get violated for nothing. And newspapers call it murder and rape. We had the same thing in my day, but we called it murder and rape then, too. Yeah.
do they?
I know it for a fact. You heard of them Gallup polls?
Sure.
I did a test once. You might find this very interesting.
Well, we don't want to keep you. You might miss out on something.
If I don't tell you about this, you'll miss out on something. I did this test once. I wanted to prove that nobody's really a louse. So, you know what I done?
No.
I stood on the corner and went up to 8 different people, told them I was lost, just to see if they'd help me.
And how many did help you?
2.
2 out of 8? That's stinking odds.
It's 100%. 4 of them didn't speak English, and 2 had lost themselves.
She's crossing the dump just like we did. She's breathing steam. Must be getting cold out. Maybe I should get some antifreeze on the way back.
Here, quick, put your rubbers on. We don't want any telltale mud on your shoes. What are you shaking with?
I never minded nobody before. It's sort of like getting married.
Gloves. Where did I put that pair of rubber gloves?
Oh, you're over there in a box full of spaghetti.
Now, remember, when you get out to the highway, don't skid, don't be seen, and take careful aim before you step on the gas.
Don't skid, don't be seen, take careful aim.
Here, wear these so you can't be identified.
Oh, hell yeah! Brad! Brad!
Look over the top! Now, we figured she'd take 4 minutes to reach the highway. You could reach it in 2, so in exactly 8 minutes, you should be back. Now, let's synchronize our watches. I have 9:15.
Like a tree toy.
Never mind. Get going. Oh, here, I'm gonna my handkerchief.
Why, is my nose running?
The windshield might fog up.
You sure you don't want to come along? No. Just for the ride?
No, somebody has to stay here and keep the warrior quiet.
Try making love to her. Sometimes that keeps the damn quiet.
Make love to her? I'm only getting 10,000. Oh, you look much better.
Where's Sala?
His license expired. He drove in to take a driving test. Where are you going?
I'm going to stop Opal from leaving this house.
You can stop her when she comes out. First, I want to talk to you. I'm not going to hit you. I've never hit anything in my life.
You're planning to do something to me.
Nothing uncivilized. Come over here, Gloria.
Why?
Do you recall something I said earlier about the corrupting influence of kindness?
What are you getting at?
Haven't you noticed a subtle change? Can't you see what's happened to me?
What?
You.
Me what?
The example of your kindness to Opal. If you could only look into my soul, Gloria, and see the seething cauldron under which you have kindled a flame.
Yeah? Well, what's cooking?
This isn't easy for me, Gloria. Believe me, it's quite an ordeal. Come over here, please.
So you can twist my arm?
You don't really know what I'm about, do you?
Don't I just...
Wait! Sit down. Please. First, I want you to understand why I wanted money.
Everybody wants money. What's to understand?
I was trained for a profession I love, but, well, you know what happened to me. I want to lift my face in the sun again. Money would make that possible. This was like my last chance. After all, I only have one lung.
Well, Opal's only got one life, and if that's all, I'm going up and helping.
Wait, don't leave me, lovely Aphrodite.
After what?
Do you know what it's meant to me? Working with you, being with you, living with you?
Who said you've been living with me?
If you only knew how many times I've banished that thought. Can't you guess why I've been deliberately harsh with you at times?
Sure, you're mean.
The only hurt that truly cuts me deep is that you know not when I weep.
What's that?
Poetry. poetry.
Macbeth?
Li Po.
Who?
Chinese.
Don't you bring me!
Gloria, I'm going to confess something to you. And when a man reveals his weakness to a woman, he makes her custodian of his dignity. Do you understand?
Frankly, no.
Gloria, meet me in our moment of truth, naked and unashamed.
Hey, I don't think you want to fool around like that. Hey, Brad! No, look here, Brad!
Don't say anything.
To Opal?
Don't talk. This belt's too tight for you, isn't it?
Some, I gotta get a hole punched in it.
Let me make you more comfortable.
Hey, now, cut out this naked and unashamed pitch. Opal's liable to come down.
Do you realize what you're doing to me?
I can guess.
What do you expect me to do then?
Recite some more poetry.
Thou art the eyes with which I see. Thou art my sweet serenity. If thou be pollen, I'll be thy bee. If I hurt thou, then I hurt me. Two vines entwined grow as a tree. Which part be thou and which be me? Parted from thou, I cease to be. If thou should die, I die of thee. Sneaked out. Why did you bring her back here?
She ain't dead yet.
I'll give the iodine.
She's gone over here in a bottle more gargle.
You fool. Why didn't you leave her?
I was innocent. I'm not gonna blame.
Take her inside, drop her in front of your car, run over her two or three times, and take her back out to the highway and leave her.
So suppose somebody sees me talking.
Pretend you stopped for a flat. Hurry. Hurry, and don't take your rubbers off.
She's disappeared.
Saul took her to the hospital.
Or I'll go with
you. He's going away.
The hospital? Do you think she's got a chance? Do you think she's got Blue Cross?
She's got Saul.
Suppose she dies.
Then you'll be a wealthy girl.
Oh, God, don't say that. It never occurred to me. In fact, it never crossed my mind.
Why don't you come back over to the couch with
me? No.
Why?
Frankly, I lost the move.
I haven't.
Don't cry. With Opal maybe dying, I couldn't concentrate.
I'll concentrate. Now, where were we? Oh, yeah.
You never even had stockings.
Oh, well, it's me. Can you hear me?
He's coming in. Grab her feet. Put her on the couch.
Okay.
What are we gonna do? He'll see her.
Don't worry. We're going to get away with murder. We're going to tell the truth.
The truth? I can't tell the truth. I look guilty when I try to cash a good check.
She's breathing.
I wish I was.
Oh, well. I found Opal's wagon out on the highway. What's the matter with her?
She was hit.
On the highway.
From behind.
Is she alive?
She was.
We'll see.
Jules, what a wall. I expected a brain pressing in on me like a ton of bricks.
Do you remember what happened, Opal?
Sure. I was hit.
Oh. Could you identify the driver?
Sure. You!
Me!
You! You son of a bozo! You saved my life!
you're going to get me rotten spoiled.
High time. Nobody's got a better ride. After all, you saved my life.
Oh, Paul, you promise.
He's just like a little boy who squirms when he's been told he could suffer my rules. And just when you are a grown-up little boy, I bet you've let people take advantage of you all your life.
Some.
You left your laundry out like I asked?
Opal, last week you washed out two of my clean shorts I never even wore. You're going to wear them out before I do.
I just can't help it. After all you've done for me, I can't help it. There ain't enough I can do for you. The very least.
Opal!
How are your eggs?
A king, Maddie.
A cook down the road at the Dixie Diner learned me how to fry eggs. Such a nice fella, real genuine. Lost one of his eyes. If you let the pan get too hot, the eggs burn and the edges curl up like a dead spider, and in the middle it'll be runny. Once a hen's done her part, it's up to a cook to do right by her.
Okay. They got no respect for food. All they respect is a fast buck.
And that's the truth. Truth, I almost forgot. What does this say, honey?
Shampoo.
It's vitamin Z. Here. Flesh up a little.
If it was a bee, you said it was good for me, I'd swallow it.
That's close, honey. It's royal jelly. It comes from bees. A nice sick man down the road that runs a health food store gave them to me. Nice, real genuine and terrible headaches. Had to have all his teeth pulled out. He explained, this jelly comes out of the queen bee. These other bees feed it as goo. Science don't know what it is yet. But this goo makes this queen lay, I don't know how many thousand eggs a day. So it's got to be dynamite. Plus, I don't know how to get it out of this queen unless they squeeze it out.
I hope I don't lay no eggs. Waitress in a bar. I picked up a beat up joint. She picks up a beat up jerk. Together they beat it with a joint bank account.
I bet she paid Dina for every minute of it.
That pig, she never even paid for her own stamps.
Well, being Dina won't make it better.
I'd stick my neck out again, but then who'd want an old rooster like me?
Oh, I don't know. They say old roosters make the best soup.
I wasn't thinking about soup. I was thinking, I'll lay it on a line. Opal, I want to pull your little wagon.
You know what I'm going to do? You can haul my bottles into town. I'll stay here and bake you a cake.
Out of your own oven?
Any flavor you want.
I never had a cake in my whole life. It didn't come out of cellophane.
What do you like in it?
A hacksaw. Jobs in the city.
No, too many people gnawing off the same bone. Say, could you eat a couple of pork chops?
Maybe in about an hour. Say, how'd you ever get in the junk business anyhow, Opal?
Oh, like the prostitute says, I guess I was just lucky.
Oh,
well, you've been your face.
She's gonna bake me a cake.
Then I better help her. She'll never find the vanilla.
I put it in the jelly jar.
That's a good woman. And she's a good cook. And if she got herself gussied up, she'd be a good-looking woman, too. When I'm in a room with Opal Cronky, I feels like I'm in a cathedral.
I know. With me, it's like I never took a deep breath before. I smell kerosene.
Oh, I spilled it filling the stove this morning. You know, life's comical, Gloria. To think I was thinking about killing her. Now I'm thinking about marrying her. Usually it's the other way around.
Good morning, Brad.
Today's the 30th. The day Charles I was beheaded and Mahatma Gandhi was assassinated. And it was also on the 30th that Hitler and Cleopatra committed suicide. And it was on the 30th that Oliver Cromwell was dragged from the gallows and had his head impaled on a pole to discourage early morning optimism. Yes, I'd say precedent favors us today. Good morning.
Well, I see you was hitting a bottle again.
Why don't you wear a red tie? It matches your eyes.
Here, Miss Gulak, spare me your pithy solicitude. Saul, we made a plan together.
Brad, we had this all out before. I changed. I got serious intentions towards Opal now.
So have I, and I want you to share them.
Brad, I flipped over a new leaf.
Saul, there's a sublimely simple way to do this. Just one of these little pills and something she drinks, she'll pass out quickly. Then before she comes to, before she can feel any pain, I will set the house on fire. It's a tinderbox. It's humane. Gloria, you are a girl of taste. Could anything be more merciful?
What's pithy solicitude?
Saul, I appeal to your honor. As a dedicated swindler, you were a man of stature. You were a tower of iniquity.
He was a bomb!
You were born with a genius for perfidy. You have no moral right to waste this prodigal talent.
What's perfidy?
I'll tell you what it is. It's cremating Opal before she's ready. Brad, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. A good mind like you playing with matches.
Frankly, I don't see how he sleeps nights.
Brad, we're your friends. We want to help you. If you was a lush, you'd go to Alcoholics Anonymous. When you're ready, you come to me in glory.
I hope when you turned over that new leaf, you noticed that the underside was a haven for earthworms.
He's just trying to hurt you, Saul.
But I ain't hurt. I'm just mad.
Poor Brad. Can I ask you something? Why did you make love to me?
You're not very bright, Gloria.
I am too bright. I just ain't quick. Why did you make love to me on that couch?
Because it was the only suitable piece of furniture.
I mean, at all.
Dear Miss Gulak, you also have a rare talent. Bordering on genius, don't ever lose it. It isn't every woman that can make stupidity as hypnotic as sex.
Sticks and stones.
Contribute something to science. Weigh my life against hers. What does she have of value to offer? Nothing.
How do you know she ain't worth nothing? Look at this house. It's full of junk. Look at the whole damn world. It's full of junky people. But like Opal says, if you save anything long enough, you just might find good use for it. And that's why, my dear Professor Winter, I'm saving Opal.
Oh, there's nothing more insidious than simple-minded goodness. It's a dripping faucet. Given enough time, it will wear away granite. Well, I haven't the time!
You
hate me, don't you?
Let's just say you're not the ideal woman I dreamed of as a youth.
Well, I'm sorry. I wish I was. I hope you find her. And I'm glad you still got your dreams. I ain't. What's she like, Brad?
The woman of my dreams? She's a beautiful, rich, young, sterile nymphomaniac.
Very funny. But you can't hurt me, Brad, because I won't let you.
Affability. Refuge for the insensitive. Well, I haven't any such refuge. You see this?
Where'd you get that?
I'm desperate now.
You're drunk!
I want something good out of life. If I don't get the money, I'm gonna use this on myself.
No, you won't.
Won't I?
No. And you know why? Because you love yourself too much.
Somebody put in the wrong box. There.
Is that milk?
I suppose you wanted cream.
Do you mind?
Get it, Paul, honey. It's in a jar marked mayonnaise. Toity, toity, His Royal Highness.
Oh! Oh, my God! Clumsy, dull elf!
Maybe he's having trouble with his kidneys. I'm not clumsy. I'm just unlucky. He blames everybody for everything just because he's a failure. Oh, I'm sure he don't do it deliberate, honey. After all, a horse is running in the rain. Splashes mud on everyone.
Yeah, he's running. Opal, I got something important I want to tell you.
I'm all ears.
Now, what I want to warn you about is Brad. He's sick, Opal, real sick.
And I got just the thing. Vitamins called royal jelly.
Opal, please, vitamins ain't the answer.
Will they help?
Opal, please. Brad's planning to do something terrible. He's got this little pill.
Oh, he's gonna kill himself. We gotta stop him.
Opal, he ain't gonna take the pill himself. Now, what I gotta tell you ain't easy. You're gonna hate me. You're gonna learn some terrible things about me and Saul and Brad.
Gloria, I made it a life policy never to listen to mean things, no matter who said them. So I just gotta be rude.
To work immediately.
Like I said, if you got friends, you don't need money.
are sometimes difficult to find.
All you gotta do is look. What was the name of that fella that went around with a lantern looking for honest men?
Diogenes?
That's him. Imagine looking with a lantern. Any fool knows you can't find an honest man roaming the streets at night. You find him in bed with his wife.
You misunderstand. He looked in the daytime.
Then he was a crackpot.
Sleepy?
And that's the truth. Diogenes, poor lonely man. Then he was a bachelor.
I swear I'll kill you. They'll find three bodies instead of one.
Now, wait a minute.
Oh, he means it.
I certainly do. We planned this together, remember? I can get at this before you can get at me, so don't try it.
You're crazy. You're nuts.
Brian, you're drunk. You don't know what you're doing. Please, please don't do it.
Throw me your matches. Fine. Thank you.
I'll take that.
Thank you.
I'll take those too. Get over there with them.
Officer, name
shut up. Turn your face to the wall.
Judas, what a kid!
Oh, back up. I guess what? Oh, these people were trying to kill you.
Joke.
You bet your life is no joke. When I came in here, that conniving crook was dousing you from head to foot. He was going to set you on fire.
No, he wasn't. I took a swig of whiskey and passed out. Really, it was just trying to bring me to.
With kerosene?
That ain't kerosene, that's water. The kerosene's in a jug marked cider.
Well, it's kerosene, I can smell it.
Water.
They've tried to kill you before.
No, that does it. You get out of here, junk Yankee. When you come in this house and run my friends down, you're wild, you're welcome.
Opal, listen to me.
No, I don't intend to listen to no mean things about friends. So you just go right away. Get!
It's been a pleasure.
I should have listened to my mother. She begged me to be a priest.
Save your dirty, stinking life!
Adrian, we can get a doctor, we can save her.
I'll go for a doctor.
If you do, you know what I mean,
give me your car keys, Saul.
You'll go to prison.
And I'll go to prison.
Oh, just what taste. Where's he going?
He's going to get a doctor, Opal.
Not for me, he ain't. They charge $10 to come on back.
I knew what was in that can, Opal.
No, you never.
I knew exactly what I was doing.
You wanted to hurt me?
Everything your friend told you was right.
And you?
I ain't gonna lie to you, Opal.
Gloria, you never wanted to hurt me.
I tried to tell you, but no, you wouldn't. You stuck your fingers in your ears.
My friends. My wonderful friends. You've done something really terrible to me. I wouldn't mind it if you take my life savings. I give you everything I got for nothing, but you took my life savings. So it wasn't me. You wanted money.
Benjamin Franklin.
I've never seen a Benjamin Franklin before. And this here sack, this is all a dollar bill.
Oh, Paul, you shouldn't be carrying around no heavy bags of money. Just sit down, dog.
But if that ain't enough, that moose up there is stuffed right up to his nose.
I knocked, but no one answered.
Hey, my doctor friend. I hope you ain't come to see Mr. Tiana.
No, Miss Cronky. No, Miss Cronky, I came to see you. You see, I have a stiff head again, and I thought you might give a little twist.
Sure enough. I always say one good turn deserves another. Hey, there's more in the moose. Doctor, you don't move in your head.
Opal doll is your tea.
Thank you, honey. You know what I'm gonna do? Make a
toast. I drink this tea to my friends. We got friends in this world. Nothing bad can happen to you. And that's the truth. God bless all good men and bad ones, too.
Twice in a row, you know, poor Opal.
Did she have
like,
makeup done? I didn't know she was hanging.
I couldn't talk to this
one. Oh, my God. The next one. Well, it seemed like you threw it in the beginning. You seemed a little off.
Well, it came out of my coat when I walked in.
I didn't see that.
Oh, my God, all the money was all over.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to rip it out of my coat.
Oh, yeah, sure.
There, thanks for coming.
Yeah,
just got me and her. Just me and Opal.
Yeah.
There you go. Stay on that
what's
for 10.
The buy,
and you
the
know.
I love you, Opal. I'm going to make out with you on the couch, baby.
No.
You met my husband yesterday.
Hi. I know.
This is Patrick. Hey, a friend of mine.
A little different.
Oh, okay. Nice to meet you. She's been a pleasure to work with. I've been on her. So talented.
At the airport, and then
she's
we
so
thought
pretty.
It was
going to
be
nice. Did you just come today?
Yes.
Wow.
This is Mark.
Hi, Mark. Nice to meet you.
Isn't he a great cop?
Good job.
There you go.
Just
good. Everybody say the doctor was pretty good tonight.
The doctor was really good.
Of course.
Look at that horn.
I know where I am.
He is the number one cameraman in the
theater.
Oh.
It's a fairy tale so tragic. There's no prince to break the spell. I will.
kiss on.